Microsoft Excel has a great feature. You probably have used VLOOKUP, and you probably have even used XLOOKUP. Between those two, my preference is XLOOKUP, but there's another great way to pull data from one sheet into another sheet, and especially when you're using it with pivot tables, we're going to use Excel's data models for this example. I will walk you through it. It is easy to do. First of all, just so you know, the two worksheets that I'm using, one's a customer worksheet with all my customer data on it. The second worksheet is an orders worksheet. Those customers placed orders. Copilot Chat actually created this Excel file for me. So that's where this fictitious data came from. Over on the customer's worksheet first, I've got customer ID, name, email. So really, just a bunch of customer information. Over on the orders worksheet, of course, I've got the order ID and the customer ID. But what I'm missing over on the orders worksheet that I may possibly want to capture is the name of the customer, possibly the city and the state, because that is not sitting over on the orders worksheet. And these are actually set up correctly in real life. This is how these two sheets should be set up. So I could, if needed, add a column and call this whatever I want the customer's name. And from here, I could either do a VLOOKUP or I could do an XLOOKUP and pull over the customer's name. My file gets larger, though, with VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP. So what I'm going to do is use Excel's data model and set up relationships to do this. So you do need to have these as tables. So I'm just going to quickly do a Control T, hit OK. I technically don't have to rename this, but I might as well call it orders. Back over on customers, make a table, Control T, OK. Customers, sounds good. Now my pivot table will be created from the orders worksheet. That's got most of the data that I want. Except let's pick the field that I want that's not over here, and that is going to be the name of the customer. So insert pivot table. Nothing new yet. It's picking up the orders table. This is the trick. Make sure you check add this data to the data model. When I click OK, new worksheet for a pivot table. If you notice, it looks slightly different over here. Very similar, but slightly different. I could move this, but I'll just stick over here and work. I want to see the order ID. Let's say I want to see the customer ID, product, and the total. That sounds good to me. Now, how do I get in that customer name over here? When I go to the All tab and expand customers, right here, I want to put in the customer's name. And I get this message immediately that says, hey, there needs to be a relationship between these tables because customers are unique. That customer number is unique to a customer. But one customer can place multiple orders. That is a one-to-many relationship. And Excel is actually trying to help me do this. I could click on Create and do it myself. But let's use the Auto Detect feature to handle this. So when I select Auto Detect, Auto Detect Relationships dialog box appears. This is, may take a few minutes. Relationship detected. Done. One new relationship created. I'm going to show it to you instead of just hitting close. And it's exactly what I would have created when I hit edit, is that the table orders has a customer ID in it. And then also the table customers had customer ID in it. And that is that one to many relationship that was created. So let me just cancel here, close that. So now that relationship is created. Before you say, Chris, your data looks horrible, I am agreeing with you. We are in agreement. This is when you would go inside your pivot table to the design tab, change your report layout from the default, which is compact, go to tabular format, and now look what we have. I have the order, the customer ID, the product that was ordered. I've got the name of the customer, and then I've got the total amount here. Just to prove this, if I pop back over to orders, order number one was customer number 5. Back over to customers, customer number 5, there is Eva Green right there. So everything is working. The file stays smaller because I'm not using vertical lookup or XLOOKUP. And it's not based, you can do this on more than just 2 tables. I possibly have a rep table, a customer table, an order table, a shipping table. You can do this with multiple tables. The key is getting those fields the same. Thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe to my Excel training along with Copilot, Teams, and OneNote. Have a wonderful day.